I got my finger caught.
Calm before the storm, right?
This is the calm before the lull. I don't expect the storm.
Since 2009, I have made almost 90 movies for the Rosenfeld Gallery, and my gratitude for their patronage is boundless. They saw something in me that I didn't even know was in there, and they gave me a chance to grow. Through the Rosenfelds, I got to meet some of the best artists and nicest people in the Philadelphia region. I have talked to many of them since we learned of Richard and Barbara's upcoming retirement, and we are all filled with love for these wonderful people who have done so much to support our creative lives. The lull before the calm that Richard joked about was in reference to an amazing party that art collector Bob Green gave on March 22nd to honor the Rosenfelds for their 40 plus years of art dealing.
So I have to talk straight from the heart. First of all, I want to thank Bob Green for this wonderful, wonderful send-off. This is just great. Not only is he giving me and Barbara a great send-off, but he and his brother have been responsible for keeping me in business. I tried to sell the gallery to him, but he already bought it. If you look around, you see just about, I'd say, 80-85% of all the paintings and art in this house, in this double house, is from the gallery. And some of the best things I've had are in this gallery. He had a wonderful eye. He always picked out the best stuff.
Well, how come he left me out?
Leaving artists out was definitely not the Rosenfelds' thing. They have built such a community of creative people, many of whom were in attendance at Bob Green's party.
This is Alden Heck, and I want to say some very sweet things about Richard and about Barbara, who, in this whole world, are the kindest, most generous, loving people who support the arts and who have soul.
This elderly art dealer is flirting with you. Are you creeped out by it?
Not at all. I'm used to it.
I just sort of trashed you a little bit, so go ahead.
You trashed me? Okay, well, I accept all the trash, and Richard is full of a lot of bad jokes.
If God didn't want us to eat pork, why did he wrap it in bacon?
And I get to hear him at least three mornings a week.
What do you think about this Larry Becker fellow?
Well, he's very funny. He's very serious. I enjoy having a cup of coffee with him every single morning. Strong coffee. It puts lead in my pencil.
Are we a good crowd here?
The best crowd. I'm so happy to have you guys. The best crowd I've ever waited on. I'll say that.
I'm Signe Wilkinson.
I met Richard Rosenfeld in the 1970s when he was having a display of Tony Auth. That got me started in cartooning in Philadelphia. I feel like I know the artists through him because he is so loyal to them and they are to him. We're going to miss Richard. Barbara, too. Bon voyage. Their grandchildren are lucky.
I'm the quiet one. I'm the strong, silent kind that helps run the gallery. When we first opened the gallery in our home in Huntington Valley, we were full partners. Richard solicited artists and customers. We had some people with us that are still with us today. Bruce Samuelson, Mary Spinelli, for example. So So I would work all day and then come home and make sure the house was perfect and with a smile on my face. We did that for a couple of years until we realized we had to move downtown.
Looking back, I find my career as a gallerist so improbable. I've kept the gallery afloat for almost 40 years, and in all modesty, played a role in the cultural life of the area. I was an unkempt, squirmy child, dyslexic and probably somewhat ADD. I wasn't good at anything, a poor, undisciplined student with bad study habits. My native intelligence alone salvaged a B average all through school. I enjoyed art classes in junior high and won an award at a regional show. Thinking maybe I was good at something after all, I took art lessons at the Settlement House and as many classes as possible at high school. I clung to the image of being an artist. I cultivated the image of an outsider. I was peculiar, but in a special way. I saw more and felt more deeply than other people. I started classes at the Pennsylvania Academy of the Fine Arts in 1957, when I was 17. I spent 5 years there drinking coffee, and chatting, and doing very little work. Fortunately, I underwent a coordinated degree program taking academic courses at the University of Pennsylvania, graduating with a Bachelor of Fine Arts degree. So I learned something. I followed it up with 2 more years of coffee and easy living at Pratt Institute in Brooklyn, receiving a Master's of Fine Arts degree in 1964. After teaching art at a boys' boarding school in Pennsburg, Pennsylvania, I took my savings and moved to Ajijic in Mexico, a small fishing village on Lake Chapala, just outside of Guadalajara. I spent a year there, occasionally staring at blank canvases and wondering more and more what the heck I was doing. By the time I returned to Philadelphia, I realized that I had become an artist only for lifestyle reasons, and it was time to stop posturing and to get on with my life. For months, an employment agency tried to place me in a job fitting my particular skills, but nothing came of it. Then I answered an ad in the paper for a manager of a mall art gallery. I got the job and, to my surprise, found I liked it and was pretty good at hanging art and selling art. 6 years later, I became a junior partner in the Langman Gallery in Jenkintown, Pennsylvania. For several years, things went well and we were representing really good quality artists, including Larry Day, Arlene Love, and Sam Maiden. In the early 70s, business fell off sharply during a severe market downturn. Consequently, we dissolved the partnership and I became a private dealer consultant working out of my house while scouting locations for a gallery. When I first saw the ground floor at 113 Art Street, I fell in love with the space. I knew that most of the city's art galleries were clustered around Rittenhouse Square. Therefore, I would always be a destination gallery. People would have to make special plans to stop in, and I could not depend on any walk-by overflow from other galleries. Opening a gallery is always risky, but I had several advantages. At Langman Gallery, Richard Langman was the businessman, and I did most of the selling and interacting with artists. When I left, many of the artists and collectors came with me. I had also developed good relations with the art critics and other people in the field. My career has been very gratifying. It's been a privilege to get close to so many talented, creative people and have access to their studios and homes. Artists have been my teachers, taking me into their confidence and sharing their views and aesthetics. At last, I understand my role. I've been an enabler. I've left my mark by standing aside and providing an encouraging, understanding environment for such capable, deeply committed artists. It's been a wonderful ride.
You're all great friends. I've been so blessed to be able to hang out with artists my whole life, artists and their significant others. Artists don't marry, for the most part, insurance salesmen. They marry interesting people. We have a lot of other interesting people here, too. By the way, you know why bagpipe players always march when they play? They're trying to get away from the sound.
Dale Wright. Roberts. I've been exhibiting with Richard for some 30 years maybe. I can't say enough about Richard. His understanding of what it is to be an artist, how hard it is to be an artist. He was an encouragement from day one. His eye, his ability to relate to so many people on so many levels will certainly be missed. Always someone that I cherish conversations with, somebody that you could count on. I think we can count on missing Richard when he goes.
This is an existential joke. What's brown and sticky? A stick. I represent about 40 artists, and we do about 8 or 9 shows like that a year. So that's just about enough so that everybody has a show when they have a new body of work.
I'm George Caligiuri. Richard, I met you 3 years ago, and you gave me the opportunity to exhibit in Philadelphia. I was glad to meet you and start the journey with you. I will be missing you.
My name is Michael Bartman, and I've been with Richard's Gallery for over 10 years. First of all, I'd like to congratulate Richard on retiring, and also for having a successful gallery for 39 years. That's no small feat. I'm really appreciative that he created a community of artists. And thanks for all these years.
Diane Pieri, and I've been with Richard Rosenfeld for 18 years, and it has all been wonderful. Richard is a fantastic person, gallery dealer. He's a mensch. It's just been an honor and a pleasure to exhibit in his gallery.
Do you ever go to student shows in search of new gallery artists?
Not anymore. In the beginning I did, but I realized that was not really fair to them or to me. I plan shows a year to 2 years in advance, and with a student, you don't know what you're going to get in 2 months, let alone a year or 2 years. And you shouldn't. That's a time where students should not have that pressure, and they should paint a lot of bad paintings and find themselves and find a voice. I don't like to show an artist until they've at least begun to find a voice.
Tremaine Smith. I've been with Richard 20 years. And you know, he rejected me a couple times before he accepted me, yeah. So we have an ongoing relationship that actually has only gotten better and better over the years, as I really value who he is as a human being, not just an art dealer. It goes way beyond that. It really goes to who he and Barbara are as people and how much they care for the artists. They love the art, they love the artists, and you can feel that.
I'm Marianne Mitchell. He is one of the most special people in my life. When I first met Richard, he ceremoniously said no to me and my work. The second time I met Richard, he said no. The third time, he opened his arms and said, whatever you want, I will support you with.
Debbie Fine. I came into this gallery. I showed Richard my work. And he said, well, come back in 6 months. 6 months later, I came back, and he said, come back in another 6 months. It was clear to me that the only gallery I wanted to be in was Richard's. This was the gallery, and I'm so thrilled that we are in a relationship now, and that I love this gallery, and I will miss both Barbara and Richard a lot.
Ed Bronstein. Richard was my first mentor when I was still a student. I stopped in here, I showed him my work, he sat with me for half an hour and said, you're good, come back. And I came back, and the third time he said, I want you in my gallery, and I really appreciate him and love him.
I'm Emily Brett Lukens. Richard and I have known each other for 35 years. I was a neighbor right around the corner here from the gallery, and he was one of the first galleries here in Old City. It's just a fabulous gallery.
I'm looking for an artist who's really committed to what they're doing and that use their work as a form of personal expression.
Louise Strawbridge. I've been showing at the Rosenfeld Gallery since about 2005. Richard had more confidence in me than I did. He allowed me to go wherever I seemed to be going without the judgment. Thank you, Richard.
Jimmy Clark. Very grateful to Richard. After returning to Philadelphia, I had no gallery, and he gave me that opportunity, and he gave me 2 solo shows, and it's been really helpful to my career. We're all going to miss it a lot. On the other hand, he's done a lot for the Philadelphia artists, and I really appreciate what he's done for me.
I'm very impressed by the multiplicity of different art styles. Every artist is different, so you'd expect the art to be different if they really are true to what they're doing and not just painting according to a trend. When they find their voice, it's usually unique.
I like to tell people that my specialty is diversity, and that is a specialty. I just like good art, and I like people that are committed to it.
Donna Quinn, I am honored and humbled and overwhelmed at all of these shows, especially the annual Small Works Show, to be part of this group of artists and to see myself on the wall with such wonderful people. I thank Richard and his wife for all of their support and for the opportunities that they've given me.
Fran Gallen. It was a dream come true when Richard got in touch with me, having seen my work on my website, thanks to Jackie Cotter, who recommended me. And it's an honor, a privilege. It's been a wonderful experience to be with the people here. It's all I could hope for.
Stephanie Lieberman, and I just started showing with Richard last year, although I've been familiar with his gallery ever since I've been coming down here to Old City and been at the Academy doing all the First Fridays. I've watched all of his artists from Alex Konevsky on start here and have these wonderful, fabulous careers, and he just has the best stable of artists. I'm going to miss everything here.
Laura Pritchard. I was at a co-op gallery. He saw my work and loved it. Hi, Richard. Thank you for rescuing me.
So I started the art gallery on a shoestring. I had saved up $10,000, and that was it. And even back in 76, that was not a lot of money. And I had to pay the rent out of that the first month. I had to pay my own living expenses. And it took me a long time to catch up to that. I was always a little bit behind. I've never made a lot of money in the gallery. But it was really, really tough in the beginning.
My first customers are here. I want you to take me a picture of them.
Oh, okay.
My name is Howard Casper. I'm his oldest customer.
Nice to meet you. I'm Nancy.
What made you want to buy stuff from Richard?
Oh, because everything he has we love. That's why.
Well, they kept me in business for 10 or 15 years.
Marion Amica is very grateful to Richard and to Barbara for all the years you've been involved in all the exhibitions and for their show of support, always.
And especially for introducing me to John Thornton.
And especially for introducing me to John Thornton.
Hi, Richard. This is Leslie Fenton. I am so overcome with gratitude and emotion and a certain amount of regret that you'll be leaving, but I'm so happy for you to be starting a new chapter in your life. But thank you for giving me the chance to show my work in your beautiful gallery all these years and to get to know you and Barbara as wonderful people and friends. And I just want to thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Catherine Stanek. Richard, I just want to thank you for that opportunity in seeing in me something that I may not have even seen in myself and that others didn't see. And that day that I came sheepishly into your gallery, interrupting your lunch to look at my work and see if you would consider showing a piece or two, and you immediately offered me an exhibition and welcomed me as a represented artist, and I'm forever grateful.
Over the years, we've done lots and lots of fundraising events for different charities, and it's been a very important part of what we do. It's the way I can give back, because I've never made really enough money to give money to any cause, but we can lend the gallery in our support. Project Home, we've done several times with Sister Mary Scallion to raise money for the homeless, and that's always been a very touching event to do here.
We're very grateful for the Rosenfeld Gallery, who's not only exhibits such beautiful art, but also uses it to support community endeavors and functions, you know, throughout the city. So it's art plus.
Val Rossman. I've been associated with the Rosenfeld Gallery my entire art career. An amazing experience. He's a fabulous dealer, insightful, witty, honest, with a great eye. I just can't believe he's leaving. Oh, very sad, but I love him dearly, and I love Barbara as well.
Ann Caramatico, every time we do a show for her, all the proceeds from her part and some of ours go to supporting a school that she funds in Cambodia.
Ann Caramanico, I've been here for about 4 years since
coming here, I've become a much better artist, and that has a lot to do with Richard and his support, encouraging me to evolve and move forward. I think he's done that for lots of artists. He's willing to hang in there with you. It's a tremendous gift. So thank you, Richard.
It's just a wonderful thing. Artists are very generous, and they do things like that all the time. Tracy Ziegler, a terrific artist that we show, is very involved with prisoners. She writes them letters, she does newspaper articles about them, she sponsors art shows. We did an art show here to raise, and those funds went into art materials for the prisoners. On the other end of the scale, we've done events for Red Paw, an arm of the Red Cross. They rescue animals who are separated from their owners at fires and disasters, rehabilitate them, then return them to their owners.
And there's one other long-term charity case that Richard has taken on. That would be me. I had switched to filmmaking after being a painter for many years. Though you artists are used to living in a way we filmmakers generally can't abide, it wasn't the money that drew me in. When Richard first hired me to make a movie for him, he made it clear that he would never interfere with what I wanted to do. Go! So even though Richard consistently paid me less than 20 large per movie, I always came back for more.
Rita Siminski-Smith, and I've been really proud and honored to be part of Richard and Barbara's gallery. They've been encouraging and supportive to all of us, and it's been rewarding in every way. They are very special people, and I'm very happy to have had them in my life.
One of the sad things about being in business so long is I've lost a lot of close friends that were artists that I showed. Dar Staffel, for one. She was in her 90s when she died, but she was still very vital. I think I've learned more from Dar about evaluating work than anybody I've ever met. She was high maintenance and very well worth it, and a really good painter. Murray Desner was a wonderful, wonderful friend. And he died much too early. He was really at his peak as an artist. It was very sad. We did a video of him right before he died, and he knew he was going to die, and it was a very poignant video. Deborah Warner was another one, and that was a last testament from her, and she was a very good friend too. She was a weaver, and she was head of the department and then dean at Moore College of Art. And she was one of those kind of people that changes other people's lives. She was very nurturing, just like Mary. The two of them were like counterparts to each other. People would spend time with them and think, gee, I want to be an artist. It's rare, but they're wonderful. Tony Auth just died. Oh man, Tony Auth came to the city just about 35, 40 years ago. And at that time I was doing a lot of political cartoons. So I contacted him right away, and we've been really good friends ever since, and we've been through an awful lot. He was just a wonderful guy. I went to a big memorial for him at the Seaside Museum, which was packed. Person after person got up and talked about, of course, Tony had a certain genius for what he did, but what everybody mentioned before, that he was just kind. He was one of the kindest people. And that's what I would like to be remembered for, to be kind. I think that's the main thing in life, be kind.
Yes.
Both of our daughters were here in cribs in the back of the gallery. They were very much part of the gallery growing up. Alex, our oldest, used to hustle Girl Scout cookies at openings.
Sam is in Perth, Australia. She is very much a writer. She works for a nonprofit that advocates for land rights for the Aboriginal people. Alex is a physician, a psychiatrist. She lives in Gainesville. Married to a physician also, Gary Wang from Taiwan, and he is a phenomenal guy. And she's got the three most extraordinary little girls.
Did she get a lot of experience with you and Richard growing up in the psychiatric field?
Oh, I refuse to answer that on account it might incriminate me.
I think I'm in the presence of the people who are stealing our beloved Rosenfelds down to Florida. Are you taking that man away from us and that lady? Uh-huh.
It was wonderful growing up in an art gallery, meeting all the artists, and of course everyone appreciates his sense of humor.
Yeah!
Do you know any jokes?
Sometimes he asks us what's the biggest pencil in the world, and then he answers Pennsylvania.
I just have to tell you, your dad is so loved around here. We are very sad that he's leaving. Your mom, too. They've just been such a treasure to the Philadelphia art scene.
Yeah. We're touched that they're leaving because I know what they're giving up. But very proud of my dad for everything he's done the past 40-ish years.
Yeah. Amazing. Really nice to meet you, and now I understand why he's going.
Oh, well, thank you.
I got started as the Rosenfeld videographer when I went to see a show of my friend Dick Rank back in 2009 and brought along a camcorder. The two of them liked me then and still like me, although they express love in an odd manner.
My name's Dick Rank. I've known Richard for 30-some years, and I've been thinking for weeks about what I might say about him, about our friendship, the effect he's had on my work, the things that I've learned from him. When you're with Richard, the conversation, the ideas often turn to you, the painter or the sculptor. He seems very interested in mining what is individual or unique about people, and less interested in talking about or revealing himself. He expects people to become their own narrator and to find their own meaning in it. I, as I'm sure most people who've worked with Richard, feel that I owe the freedom of change and growth in my work to him.
You know, this movie may be longer than Ben-Hur. Is that all right?
As long as no horses are killed in the making of the movie.
Though all good things must come to an end, dragging them out is always a good idea. I was the first person to arrive at the Bob Green party and the last to leave. All right, Bob, can you just tell me, what do you think of Richard Rosenfeld?
An institution.
It's cool.
Wonderful.
Get back. Come here. An institution. He's wonderful.
A wonderful part of Philadelphia's history and culture. And I love it.
This was such a great party. You don't know me from Adam, but I am very grateful for this. I'm making a movie about Richard. And
you are? That's
yes.
Awesome.
And you guys will be in it.
I was really little and I wanted to buy a painting because Dad said we were going to Rosenfeld. I brought like four jars of coins and we had to lug them and it was super heavy. And I was able to buy a little kitten painting. And I got to put the little red sticker dot on it, and I was so proud of myself, and it is still in my room to this day.
Thank you very much. What's the name of your place?
Jack's Firehouse.
You want to put a plug in?
Jack's Firehouse. It's on 22nd and Fairmount in Philadelphia. Great food, great service, always with a smile.
You guys did it.
Enjoyed the night.
Oh, we had a wonderful time. Yay, Jack's Firehouse.
Yay, Jack's Firehouse. Woo!
Let's hear one more joke and then bring this movie to a heartfelt and cheesy conclusion.
Man is walking past an insane asylum and he hears the lunatics on the other side of the fence chanting 13, 13, 13. And it's one of these tall fences made out of wire with slats of plastic woven through. So he peels back some of the plastic and looks in and he gets poked in the eye. And then he hears 14, 14, 14. That's it.
All right, you guys, you probably want to go play, right?
Yeah.